So in this class we are going to discuss about the pollination. So pollination is a wonderful mechanism which helps food, which provide food and shelter for pollinating animals. As well as you know, some flowers are modified for some of the animals only they can go for pollinating. According to that, the flowers are modified. So here both plants and animals are coexist, co-evolution, they live together. So imagine if a situation, if there is no pollination, what would happen? Is there any possible method for formation of fruit and seeds? Is there any possibilities to provide food for pollinating animals? No. So here comes the significance of a pollination. So pollination is a very, very important event. Okay. So pollination, the pollen grain which is produced by the stamen, it need to be transferred into the stigma. Then only it will germinate. Okay. So that mechanism of transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma is called pollination. Transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma is called pollination. So pollination in angiospermic plants, pollination where does it happen? It is especially spermatophytic plants. Pollination takes place in spermatophytes. What are called spermatophytes? Seed-bearing plants. Okay. Seed-bearing plants are called spermatophytes. So take for example gymnosperm. And angiosperm. Gymnosperm and angiosperm. So these are the two seed-bearing plants. So in gymnospermic plants, the pollination is direct. Okay, since it is having naked seed, naked ovule. Naked ovule is present in the gymnospermic plants. Therefore, here the pollination is direct. Whereas in angiospermic plants, the pollination is said to be indirect. Since the pollen grain need to be transferred into the stigma, then it will go to the style, then ovary. From the ovary, the ovule will be present. Okay, so therefore the angiospermic plant, the pollination is said to be indirect. So here the question, what is the difference between the gymnospermic and angiospermic pollinating plants? So this is a two mark motive. So most of the angiospermic plants, which is having jascogamous flower. So what is jascogamous flower? Jascogamous flower. Jascogamous flower. So most of the angiospermic plants will be having jascogamous flower. Jasmo means it, the flower get open and it exposes its reproductive organ, stamen and stigma out. So that the pollination will be happening. So that is called jasmogamous flower. So some of the angiospermic plants will be having clistogamous flowers also. Clistogamous. Clistogamous. Okay, clistogamous flower. So clistogamy or clistogamous flower. Here the flower doesn't get open. It does not expose its reproductive organ out of it. As a result, it only follow the self-pollination. It is regarding clistogamous flower. So in a majority of angiospermic plants, it is a jasmogamous flower, open type of flower, and some of them will also be clistogamous flower. Okay, this is regarding types of flower. Next one, based on the transfer of pollen grain from anther to the stigma,
pollination is divided to two types. One is self pollination. So one is a self-pollination. Self-pollination means it is orthogamy. Another one is a cross-pollination. Allogamy. It is a Greek word. Orthogamy means it is a Greek word. Ortho means self. Gamy means marriage. Okay. So marriage between the same plants. It is called the orthogamy or self-pollination. So self-pollination here possible. What is the possibility? Only bisexual flower. Okay, if there is a bisexual flower, then there is a possible of self-pollination. So there are some mechanisms which are promoting the self-pollination. What are the mechanisms? Cleistogamy flower, homogamy, and incomplete diplogamy. These are the three important mechanisms which promote the self-pollination. So first one, let us discuss what is cleistogamy. Okay, cleistogamy means, as I say, the flower get open and exposes its reproductive organ. Okay, it is called cleistogamous flower. It is noticed in Camelina, Viola and Axillaris. So Camelina is one of the common bee. Okay, where we notice cleistogamous flower. So in Camelina bengalensis, so self pollination, cleistogamy flower, Camelina bengalensis, so it is one of a common bee. So in this bee, in this plant, we will be noticing two types of flowers. Two types of flower. Two types of flower is noticed. One is on the aerial and another one is on the underground. Okay. So aerial, on the aerial part, aerial, where we have brightly colored flower, that flower is jasmogamous flower. Jasmogamous. So jasmogamous flower is noticed in the aerial part and which is brightly colored and it get open and it exposes the reproductive organ, stamen and the stigma for pollination. So here the insect pollination is taking place in the aerial flower, since it is brightly colored and a jasmogamous flower. Underground, a flower is noticed. Underground rhizome, if it's rhizome, a flower is noticed, that is called cleistogamy flower. Cleistogamy flower does not get open and it does not expose its reproductive organ, it is called a cleistogamy. Is it not? So this type of flower is noticed in the underground. So Camelina bengalensis is said to be jasmocleistogamous flower. Okay, explain what is jasmocleistogamous flower with an example. This is asked for 2 mark. Okay. So next one, homogamy. Homogamy. So it is based on the maturity of the stamen and the pistil. Homo means same. At the same time, the stamen and the pistil get matured. Therefore, it is called homogamy. So homogamy means stamen and pistil get matured at the same time. As a result, the self-pollination will be encouraged. Okay. Mirabilis chalapa is an example. Mirabilis chalapa. And Catharina scotiensis is another example for the homogamy. And incomplete dichogamy means stamen and pistil get matured at a different time. So here the maturation of stamen and pistil is different time. Therefore, it is said to be incomplete dichogamy. But the stamen and the pistils, which are arranged, which are overlapped with each other, as a result, it encourages the self-pollination. So with this, the self-pollination is over. Next one, cross-pollination. Cross-pollination is otherwise called as dichogamy. Dichono means dichono, meaning neighboring flowers. Pollination takes place between the neighboring flower. It is called dichono. Geno means strange flower. Geno means strange. Okay, dichono means neighbor. So, neighboring flower. So, first of all, let us discuss what is dichogamy. So, here dichogamy, the pollen deposit on the flower of the different plant, different flower of the same plant. Since it is having monoecious plants. Monoecious plants, we know monoecious plants. So, this is a plant which is having okay, this is a female flower and unisexual flower and this is a so this is a male flower and this is a female flower. Okay, here the possible for the transfer of pollen grain is by dichogamy. So here functionally it is a cross pollination since pollen grains are transferred from one flower to another flower. But it is the same plant. It is a same plant. Therefore, it is called a dichogamy. Okay, dichogamy, which prevent the which is said to be which is also similar to autogamy. Next one, xenogamy. So xenogamy means it is a purely of cross pollination. Xenogamy, xeno means strange flower. Pollination between the one flower to another flower of the same plants or a different plant. It is called a xenogamy. So here the pollen grains will be having genetically different as well as another flower of the different plant of the same species. The pollen grains will be transferred. It is called a xenogamy. So xenogamy consequences of cross pollination. Consequences means the mechanism which promote the cross pollination, which is said to be contrivances of cross pollination. What are the contrivances? Dichogamy and monogamy. Dichogamy means unisexuality. The flower which is present, male and female flowers are present separately, which is said to be dichogamy. Example, monoecious plants. Monoecious coconut, bitter gourd, and maize are an example for the monoecious plants. So both male and the female flowers. So this is the male flower. And this is the female flower. Which are present in the same plant. But the sex organs are present in different flower. Therefore it is called monoecious plants. So here cross pollination is possible. Only cross pollination, just like dichogamy. So dichogamy here, dichogamy is taking place. Then next one, dioecious plants. So dioecious plants means both male and female sex organs are present in separate plants. So this is another plant where we will be having So this is the female flower and this is the
male flower.
So male flower is present in one plant and the female flower is present on the other plants. So which is said to be dioecious. So here only possible method for pollination is cross pollination only.
So dioecious is example boroses, palm tree and Carica papaya is an example for the dioecious plants.
Okay, dioecious means both male and the female present are female flowers are present in different plants. It is called the dioecious.
Then monoclymy or bisexuality.
Monoclymy or bisexuality. So here the plants are having bisexual flower.
Flowers are
bisexual, but there is a mechanism. Dichocamy. First one, you see a dichocamy. Dichocamy means here based on the maturity of reproductive organ, stamen and the pistil get matured at the different time. Okay, this mechanism helps for the cross pollination.
Okay, first one, protandry.
So protandry means androecium.
So here the word
androecium get matured earlier than that of the pistil.
Okay, so that is called protandry.
Example,
clinodendron.
Clinodendron is an example for the
protandry.
Then protogyny.
Protogyny means, so you can split the word.
Gyny means gynecium. Okay, the gynecium get matured earlier than that of the stamen.
Okay,
so here the maturity of the stamen and pistil is different. So based on that, protogyny and protandry. These are the two types.
So protogyny, example Scrophularia. This is an example for protogyny.
The next one, Hercogamy. Hercogamy means here the plants will be having, even though it is bisexual flower.
Okay,
it won't take, self-pollination won't take place. But it encourages the cross-pollination. So how does it happen? So there is a physical barrier between the stamen and pistil.
So that is called a Hercogamy.
So take for example, Gloriosa superba.
Gloriosa superba. And this is a female flower.
Female stigma style ovary is there and this is the anther.
So this is the Gloriosa superba flower.
Sengandhapu. In Tamil it is called as Sengandhapu.
So where you can see this is the stigma and this is the stamen.
Okay. The stigma is far away from the stamen. It is a physical barrier. So there is a far away from the stamen. The stigma is placed far away from the stamen. As a result, there is a only possible cross pollination is possible.
Okay.
So some other example, hibiscus also you could see. The stamens are placed above the
a layer.
So there is a hibiscus. Even halotrophies you could see.
Halotrophies, pollinium is there.
Yes sir, ma'am.
So pollinium, what is pollinium?
So where will be having pollen grains are present inside a membrane. Pollen grains are present inside a membrane. Even the stigma is here. So this is a stigma. Even the stigma is here. The membrane is barely here. Here the physical barrier is
the membrane.
If the membrane is present, then there is no self-pollination will not take place. Only where the cross-pollination will be there.
So it is one of the Hercogamy.
Hercogamy means physical barrier by which cross-pollination only encouraged.
Then next one, Heterostyle.
Hetero means different. Style means two different flower.
Okay, Heterostyle. Dicyle.
So heterocyle first. Dicyle.
So dicyle we could see two
two different flower. So between the same length of the anther and the stigma, the pollination will be there. That is called the dicotyledy. Okay, even though it is having two different flower, where the cross pollination is possible between the same length of the flower, that is called the dicotyledy. Then primula plant is an example for this dicotyledy. Trisyedy means three different flower is noticed. So this is called trisyedy. Trisyedy means three different flower. The plant which is having three different flower, it is called a trisyedy. Example, Lithra. So you can look at the picture now. So where we have a long pistil is here. Okay, here the long stamen is here. So between the same length of the stamen and the pistil, the pollination is happening. See, between these the pollination will be there. Then here from this anther, the pollen will be transferred to this stigma. Then here, from the anther, here to here, the pollen grain should be transferred. So in this way, the trisyedy, the pollination only here, the cross pollination is possible. So between the same length of the anther and the stigma, the pollen will be transferred. It is called a trisyedy. The next one, self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Self-sterility or self-incompatibility. Last one. What is that? Self-sterility means the pollen grains, when it is falls in the same plants, okay, it won't get germinated. Okay, this is a special mechanism. When the pollen grains falls on the same flower or same plants, it won't germinate. When it is falls on the another plants of the another flower, then it will germinate. That is called self-sterility or self-incompatibility. It is noticed in Apitra and Passiflora, even Nicotiana plants. Okay, these are the contrivances of cross-pollination. First one, dicliny and monocliny. Dicliny is divided into two. One is the monoecious and dioecious, and monocliny is further divided into two. Dichogamy and heterogamy, heterocycline. Okay, heterocycline. So these are the mechanism which promote for the cross pollination. Thank you.